Senator Bob Corker called the White House an adult daycare center after President Donald Trump called his fellow Republican a coward for not seeking a third term. Trump lit up the Tennessee lawmaker in a series of tweets on Sunday, saying Corker had begged him for an endorsement before deciding to retire from the Senate. The attack followed a few days after Corker noted chaos in Trump's White House. "Senator Bob Corker begged me to endorse him for re-election in Tennessee," Trump said Sunday in a series of Twitter posts. "I said no, and he dropped out, said he could not win without my endorsement." Trump told his Twitter followers that Corker didn't have the guts to run. "Corker wanted to be Secretary of State. I said no thanks," Trump added. Corker tweeted back, writing, "It's a shame the White House has become an adult daycare center. Someone obviously missed their shift this morning." The senator has about 148,000 followers on Twitter to Trump's 40 million. Yet on Sunday, Corker's message was retweeted more than 113,000 times and liked more than 307,000 times. In an interview with the New York Times on Sunday, Corker said that Trump was treating the presidency like a reality show, and that his threats to other countries could set the nation on the path to World War III. He added that nearly every Senate Republican shared his concerns. "Look, except for a few people, the vast majority of our caucus understands what we're dealing with here," the New York Times quoted him as saying. Corker said that Trump regularly makes statements on Twitter that are not true. Corker Chief of Staff Tom Womack told the Associated Press Sunday that Trump called Corker last week and asked him to reconsider his decision not to seek re-election. The president reaffirmed that he would have endorsed Corker, AP quoted Womack as saying. The tweets came after Corker, chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, said Wednesday that Secretary of State Rex Tillerson, White House Chief of Staff John Kelly, and other top administration officials help separate us from chaos. Tillerson this week sought to play down reports of his own tension with the president, including one from NBC that said he'd called Trump a moron. Twitter insults. Corker, 65, is among a growing list of critics, political opponents and others whom Trump has attacked on the social media platform, from the mayor of San Juan, Puerto Rico, to actress Meryl Streep, to the cast of Saturday Night Live. Trump claimed the twatterm senator, whose votes are crucial to the president's agenda in a Senate divided 52-48 in the Republican Party's favor, is also largely responsible for the horrendous Iran deal. Corker in fact opposed the deal, which was negotiated by the Obama administration. Corker, a deficit hawk who also serves on the Budget Committee, has expressed concern that Trump's tax cut plan could cause a sharp increase in the federal deficit. Although he agreed to a budget deal that would let tax writers claim that tax cuts of as much as $1.5 trillion will pay for themselves, he's made clear he may force Republicans to scale back their plans, and he called deficits a greater threat to us than North Korea or the Islamic State terror group. Negative voicei would fully expect Corker to be a negative voice and stand in the way of our great agenda, Trump tweeted on Sunday. Later Sunday, Trump tweeted, "Bob Corker gave us the Iran deal, that's about it. We need health care, we need tax cuts reform, we need people that can get the job done." After supporting Trump during the 2016 election, Corker has distanced himself from the president on some issues, with several critical comments coming since Corker announced his retirement from the Senate on September 26. He told reporters Wednesday that he's maybe freer to speak his mind because of the decision not to run again, a development that one top White House official described in positive terms shortly before Sunday's tweet by Corker. "It's going to be fun to work with him, especially now that he's not running for re-election," Office of Management and Budget Director Mick Mulvaney said on NBC's Meet the Press. "It sort of unleashes him to do whatever and say whatever he wants to say." With assistance by Laura Litvin and Laurie Asayo.